Potentially Stefan Kloss, or
I can't imagine Big Perso. Big Perso couldn't have been a
Sasha
great dresser.
Papac potentially.
I
Big
can see
Stefan
this.
used to wear this. Big Stefan used to wear this woolly jumper every day.
Mate, I've seen
Horrendous
photos of
support.
that, I'm sure, in the old Rangers news back in the day. Stefan Kloss with a woolly jumper and all that one, and kind of bootcut jeans.
What a wonderful goalie and a great top, honestly top man, but by God his jumper was shocking.
Is it? I think I read something no long ago. Is it true that Stefan Kloss, like, he's not really that interested in football? He's meant into like biking and all that.
He was a really intelligent guy, like Stefan, unbelievable goalie. I think it's no coincidence that Greigs is obviously as good as he is. Some of the goalies that he was understudy to, do you know what I mean, the standards that they had. I was lucky that Pirzos and Stefan Klosses, etc., were all there when I first joined, so you got an insight into like real top players. But I'm not so sure he was that bored about his clobber or that bored about football, but what a wonderful goalie he was. Probably Barry Ferguson.
I knew you were going to say that.
Baz is listen, brilliant captain, unbelievable player. Demander, you need to be able to handle that to get up to Baz's standards. But he did have the odd wee wobble when he sometimes misplaced a pass about 10 yards and blamed somebody else that was on the other side of the pitch. So
Tell you what, the boys in the Celtic dressing room must be delighted that he's away there now. Mate, I remember. I don't know if I've mentioned this to you boys before, but I played in the Legends game at
Oh
Ibrox.
yeah.
Kevin was there. Kevin looked after me and
I was
Jordan.
On Scotland today.
Was it?
Yesterday, I
was it really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll talk about that later. Anyway, talking about Barry Ferguson being the monist, I remember Derek Ferguson was in our team. Do you remember, mate?
I do.
I think it was half time and he came in and Derek Ferguson was going like that. The wee man's fucking raging. He's raging. And he was raging. I remember, I think the second half, especially when McCoy's came on and scored a couple of, I think he got a hat trick the second half. And one of the goals, Barry Ferguson was going off his and you're going, I'm loving my life. I'm going like, but I think I put a bad tackle into him in the first half. The growler he gave me, man.
Yeah,
How you fucking did?
Unbelievable player, but he liked the wee whinge, Baz, but he was brilliant for me. He looked after me, to be fair, obviously centre midfield player, so he was,
Aye.
In my opinion, as good as a Scottish midfielder in the last couple of decades. He was a
Not
real,
easy.
real top player. Like, I played with a few monsters, to be fair. Kurt Broadfoot was an animal, serious animal, absolute beast in the gym, brilliant teammate. Got a bit of flak, to be fair, off the Rangers fans for his achievements, but unbelievable professional, tough as nails. Also played with a guy called Andre Beattie at Middlesbrough. And probably I'm saying best, I don't know if that's the best way to describe it. One of the biggest fights I've seen in training was Nicky Bailey, Londoner, great lad, and Andre Beattie. I don't know how I ended up in the middle of it, but if I was to describe like two big crusts of bread and I was a wee bit of ham in the middle, is what that fight looked like.
It's like John getting in the way of me and Toll having a square go.
Two fucking rich crackers with some Dairy Lee.
I played with a boy called George Friend at Middlesbrough. He was a poster boy, left back, country boy, posh boy, top player.
Was he not a model, Kevin, at some time, George
I think
Friend?
He might have been. He was another really intelligent lad. He'd done like journalism and he actually used to write a wee bit for the club website. Real nice fella. Pretty much took Middlesbrough by storm. He come in as a wee bit of an unknown quantity and I think quite a cheap option, to be fair. Proper kicked on. I think eventually he'd become the club captain maybe when I moved on, but he was a proper good looking lad. Like,
he's getting it. And then for the looks,
I'm just realised that he never chose Scott Brown to back him up in a fight.
Well,
cause I've been up the tune many a time with Scotty. To be fair, like I was lucky to play at a level, to be fair, that like I think when you get to a certain level, boys that you play with are not that bored about being a manager's pal. And they didn't need that reassurance. I think the game's changed a wee bit. I was probably more, I think back to like being 18, 19 and Tony Mowbray was like a father figure to us, and it was, if the manager passed you in the corner, in the corridor, you were desperate for him to say morning and how you getting on, son, blah, blah, blah. But by the time you get to Rangers and you find your personality and you find your mojo in the game, at the top level, it becomes less important that people like you, to be honest, because you just become that hardy, robust, look after yourself type professional, if you know what I mean. I've seen Charlie Adams speaking about getting stick, etc. You do need to have thick skin. So I think teacher's pet, cannot think of one off the top of my head, to be fair. I'd be throwing somebody under the bus if I gave you the name.
Scott Brown it is then.
Skillful, played with some unbelievable players, but skill to me was how good a football player you were, rather than showboating tricks and tricks. Pedro Mendes was bar none the best player I played with. Obviously, you'd be lucky, Stephen, to play with him in that Legends match.
Played with him in the Legends match, guys, played with Pedro Mendes, and honestly, getting changed in the dressing room with him, man, he's like, still what an Adonis. Honestly, what was he like?
Who's in better shape, him or Big Ammo?
Oh, easily Mendes.
Who got the most ass?
He's probably one of the actual could he won, but he could win best dressed, he could win the coolest.
Just one of the bampots, man, that just is
the only time I seen he's cool go a wee bit is when Jimmy Bell came in and cracked a joke about him being Pedro Caixinha's agent.
Imagine that went down like a lead blow.
Aye, that didn't go down well. But it was what a player he was. I mean, one of the best.
So tricks and flicks. He was more just a one-touch footy player around the corner, nutmegs. I still think of him like Aidan McGeady was an unbelievable player, top player. And he played in that 4-2 game, and we went down to 10 men. I remember us breaking away and taking a bit of pressure, and he actually megged Aidan on the counter attack. I think he looked after the ball. Somebody had a kick at him. Aidan went charging back to try and get the ball off and megged him. To me, that's skill and quality and just knowing your awareness, what's round about you, etc. So for me, Mendes, like, no showboating skills, but just an unbelievable footy player with unbelievable talent.
You not megged him that bad, he ended up in Moscow.
I'm not so sure he was that bored about that, to be fair. I've played with a few, to be fair. It's funny because the one that comes to mind straight away, thinking the worst trainer, but he was a brilliant player. Done really well for Celtic, done really, really well for Middlesbrough, would be Barry Robson. And he'd probably be the first to say that he was a terrible trainer. He used to make me laugh. So we'd always get a ball out at the start of training and pop it around. And obviously, lucky enough to train on nice pitches, so they're always wet and slick. So you get a wee touch of the ball, and Baz would walk right through the wee triangle or the wee group of players knocking the ball around, and he would kid on that he wanted to get involved, and he just boot the ball away. he was a really sluggish, scrappy type trainer, to be fair, but he would be one that if you were in the trenches, Barry Robson would be right by your side, like a real good player, lovely left peg, brilliant delivery, proper man's man for me. You would want him in the trenches with your Robbo, but I have to say, if you come to pick your side, five a sides for training, he wouldn't be in it.
He's not in it.
Well, I played with a few tight ones, I'm going. There was a boy called Matthew Bates at Middlesbrough, top player, centre back, real bad injuries. I think he had five, potentially six ACL injuries, and obviously, so we become quite tight because we spent so much time in the physio room together. I spent a lot of time in the gym, but he was one that I become really pally with, and he was as tight as two coats of paint, like cake as well. more money than a horse could shite, but he was as tight as they come. Like, it didn't matter if you were going for sweeties before games or if you were getting bottles of juice in or you're getting coffees in, basically would always be the back of the queue. Like. Probably you'd be happy that he's going to get a mention. Probably Scotty, I would imagine.
There you go, Tol. There you go.
Hands across the divide for Old Firm Week.
I think they are like upbringing when we were young, and obviously it sounds stupid, but see these big training centres and all the stuff that you get when you get to the top, and obviously as the game's evolving, which is brilliant. Our upbringing was jumping in cars and having to drive to training pitches here, there and everywhere in Edinburgh. But a lot of times training with dog dirt on the pitches, etc. And the youth team having to get there first to set up goals, etc. And the pitches could be like uncut, could be one side of the town one day, one side of the town the other. But I think when it comes to mucking around with people's cars or cutting people's socks or putting deep peat in people's pants or flooding the baths or just being a menace, it would be Scotty. But Listen, everybody knows how good a mate he is, he mine. And it wouldn't matter what divide, I would always stick up for him. Top lad, top player, unbelievable career, but you wouldn't want to end up with like a raw fish in your glove compartment if you mucked with
But that's kind of, I think I've said this a few times on this show, it's a couple of, we had Barry Ferguson and Bob Malcolm on together. Oh, that was about a year ago, it was our first ever show,
yeah,
I think.
It was our first show.
And they were saying that, like people like Alan McGregor and Scott Brown, it's like kind of last of the old guard of the characters in the game. There's not so many characters in the game anymore, and I think Scott Brown definitely, Barry Ferguson said that, it's only him and McGregor, he said, left really in the game. You know what I mean? You don't get players like that anymore.
You need them, to be fair. I always respect like the modern day player, the current player, the player that's playing in the same position you played for different teams or whatever. I would never ever compare because I don't think you can, but I would say, thinking like looking at our changing room at Kelty and getting an insight of being the manager and then being obviously in the B team with Rangers, you do still have characters and you have a great camaraderie. It's probably like players have got different opportunities now and different stuff to distract them from actually being together. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that then takes away from team bonding or team morale, etc. But like a lot of players like myself now, you're never off your phone. Do you know what I mean? Like whereas when we were younger at Easter Road, I think back to that batch that come through, like the only thing you could literally do was have a game of pool or stay in the stadium and muck about in the turnstiles. Do you know what I mean? I.e. like one touch, heady tennis. Like so the togetherness was almost unbreakable. Whereas the game, as it gets that wee bit older, people have got families, they're getting away, do you know what I mean? It's like the world that we're going in just now, obviously with society that we're living with COVID. It's amazing how these wee things can, I'm not saying go against the modern day player, but it's probably easy to judge one era to be different from the other, if that makes sense.
That's better than any answer. That's better.
Amazing.
Listen, I've always been respectful of other players, but there's a few songs that go about a few certain players in there.
I thought
just say Alan McGregor, Kevin, come on.
I never said that.
You never said that.
He must have worked with Hazel Irvine and all.
Aye, listen, I've been lucky. Like I played with Jonathan Woodgate at Middlesbrough, who was unbelievable, and he was his body was broken by the time I got a chance to. But great insight. Listen, played with Real Madrid. I remember Harry Redknapp saying that he was the best centre back that he ever had at Spurs, and that was like at the time where like the top England centre backs were kicking about. If you know what I mean, he says he wouldn't change him for anyone. So Woody would be up there. I just think for Mendes, I was lucky to play with Davo, obviously, who's a wonderful player. Scotties, loads of players. It feels like almost no nice to leave anyone out as such, because I genuinely do have a lot of respect for a lot of the players that I played with. But listen, there's always ones that you didn't like. That's just the way footy is. But at the same time, I'd like to think I was a proper teammate, and it didn't matter whether I was like what you done or no. But Mendes, to me, just overall package, just proper gentleman, humble, respectful, i.e. the way I like to conduct myself as well. So we hit it off, and we didn't have millions and millions in common, if you know what I mean. Different ages, etc. I would play the same position, but he was brilliant for me. I think he'd been out injured, etc. And the time that he gave me, and I remember him doing an interview about me coming back. And listen, sometimes you get these interviews that people press almost ignite it and they make that story themselves, but he spoke about like me being one of the biggest signings ever for Rangers coming back, but we didn't need to sign anyone else. It was like a new signing. So wee things like that, 10 years on, sticking the back of your throat a wee bit. So it's a brilliant footy player, and as you know, Stephen, like you get to rub shoulders with him a wee bit. He's a class act, isn't he?
Oh man, absolute.
Some agent, I know.
Hey, come on now, stop it.